Chinese proverb that says if you have one clock, you know what time it is. If you have two, you don't. I will keep to 10 minutes, I promise you that. I was asked what I was going to speak on, and 2 years ago, I was asked to speak, and I did something on the new nature of learning that I felt was coming in to the 21st century, and literally focused on when I went to school, you were asked to sit, listen to factual information in large lecture halls, copy it down, and in my estimation, vomit it back at a professor in about 8 weeks, where he or she dutifully sat, and as much as you regurgitated it back to you, that was what was considered education. It had to be that way because the first class I walked into at the University of Massachusetts at Amherst had 480 students in it, in psychology 101. That was fine then. There's a whole new world out there that fits us, and I just want to give you a quick version of what we did 2 years ago and then try to take it to another level. The amount of information in the world doubled from 1750 to 1900. That's an incredible feat. It doubled again from 1900 to 1950. It doubled yet again from 1950 to 1965. From 65 to 75, information available to the world doubled yet again. 1975 to 1978, it doubled in only 3 years, and since the advent of the 1980s and 1990s, it's been doubling every 2 years. When you folks are in mid-career, all you Alpha Chi recipients and honorees, when you're in mid-career, about 20 years from now, around the year 2010, be happy to know the amount of information in the world is going to be doubling every 72 days. So if it takes you 72 days to read an encyclopedia, you're outdated by the time you finish reading that.
Hi, I'm Jessica Grova, and I'm a sophomore at Mount Ida studying funeral service.
Your name again?
Agnes James.
Is that A as in firecracker?
Yes, Agnes James.
Sorry, I have no record of you on the computer.
You don't?
Rodriguez, Becca Lopez. The castle. Caps is going to take this one. NBA three. Good!
Another great play
that he had. Coming out of Quincy Bass. Best ball. Still by Castle. Fast break.
Can we get a dunk?
But nope. Very nice play.
You can't do single-handedly at this point.
He's like, give me the ball. Look at him. He's like, give me the ball. But Ralph says, don't. I got it.
Wow.
My name is Ian Waddell. I'm a resident assistant. I'm a sophomore, and my major is human services. A lot of residents here tend to think that RAs just want to get in their business and get them in trouble, things like that, and they tend to get upset with us.
I'm Christopher Lapierre, and I'm an RA. Major goal for an RA is to maintain your residence halls to make sure that they're a safe and quiet environment for the rest of the residents.
For me, I see this as a job. This is a job for me. I get paid. I need to pay my bills, and that's really it for me. It is a job. Right now on campus, I say there's about 18 resident assistants. And every one of us has been through 2 weeks of training. And in those sessions, they taught all of us how to deal with, or how to assist residents in any way that we can. Whenever they need anything, whenever, we can help. So, we've all been training.
Sarah. teacher is vibrant and people are nice. This year, students were mostly concerned about food.
Hi, my name is Greg Haywood. I am a student here at Mount Ida College. I'm a senior, and my major is media production. Here at Mount Ida, we know how hard it might be to find something to do, but many students found time to hang out with their friends. A lot of students took time away from their books to get fit in the weight room while spending time with their peers. Spend a lot of time at the food court in the student center, you know, just relaxing, getting a bite to eat, and not doing that, there's also a TV lounge there that they can kick back and relax and watch a little TV after class.
clean, everybody. Clean. It's clean. Okay, we're at the Sharon and Needham. Are you having a good time tonight?
Yeah, I am. I just wish more people were here to experience the good time I'm having.
Been to all the psychics and everything like that. So, do you really think she was good or what?
Yeah, she's good. I'll give it to her.
How are you?
Hello, I'm fine.
Are you gambling or are you just watching?
Oh, just watching.
This night is all about winning. You know what I mean? It's all about winning. And we love winning. Wonderful that the school is able to put something like this together, and I hope this tradition continues. I like this. This is really something that the whole school can participate in, and I'm enjoying myself.